Well, howdy there, Speak Your Mind. It's Rodney here, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about the six essential elements that are present in any great speech, talk, or presentation. And in order to more clearly see the strengths and weaknesses of those six elements in spoken communication, we're going to be comparing the same six elements as they are in written communication. So that would be things like writing a blog, writing an essay, really writing anything that you're going to put out for public consumption. And speaking of public consumption, the first element of great publicly spoken communication is considering the audience. To really get a sense of how important an audience is to you, I want you just to close your eyes and imagine, and maybe even pause this video, and imagine what it would be like to write a blog post, publish it, and not get any response back and not know how people felt about it. And more relevantly, imagine you crafted a speech, you practiced it, and you delivered it to your bedroom wall. The only feedback you get is the sound of your own voice. Now that should give you a sense of how important an audience is, whether you're writing for that audience or actually speaking to that audience. One of the critical things an audience gives you is feedback. Now, when it comes to writing a blog post and publishing it, you may get feedback in terms of reads and likes and comments. If you submit an essay to a professor or teacher, you may get comments, you get a mark, you may even have a sit-down session to discuss the essay. Now, imagine an audience of 30 people sitting there watching your every move and listening to your every word. And now you've got real-time feedback. You've got people frowning and smiling and otherwise being preoccupied. But that feedback is immediate and visceral, and it gives you a good sense of how your words and your actions and your message are landing. When you're writing a blog post, it's typical that you imagine the reader in as much detail as possible and then write to that reader. But when you're giving a speech, you don't have to imagine your listeners. They're right there in your face. They're a part of your speaking experience. And this is why speaking to a live audience demands that you adapt your message to that audience. And this is done through what's called audience analysis. Now, this can be done by asking some very basic questions like, who will be in the audience and what is the demographic makeup of the audience? And what do they know about my topic, and what would I like them to know about it after I finish speaking, and how do they feel about my topic, and how would I like them to feel about it after I finish speaking? The answers to these questions will shape the overall goals of your speech, and they'll determine the kinds of information you include, and probably even determine how you deliver it. Now let's talk about the context in which a communication, whether it's written or spoken, is actually received. With a written work, you can't really adapt it to the situation under which it will be read. It could be in the morning or the evening, it could be in a quiet environment, a noisy environment, it could be read on paper or on a screen. But because a speech is delivered at a specific time, in a specific place, you can adapt the contents and the delivery style to the overall speaking context. So what sort of things should you consider when taking the speaking context into account? Here are a few basics to consider. How much time do you have to speak? What is the overall speaking environment like? What time of day are you speaking, and what day of the week are you actually delivering your talk? All of these will determine your overall delivery style. The speaking context will also determine the best delivery style. So, do you want to speak off the cuff in an impromptu fashion? Do you want to have limited speaking notes? Do you want to memorize the entire thing, or is it important enough that you actually want to read from a prepared manuscript? For example, if the speaking context will be highly emotional, like a eulogy, or where you need to get every single word exactly right, then a prepared manuscript is probably the best delivery style. And now let's talk about content. When a reader is reading a written work, they have the benefit of reading at their own pace and visually seeing the overall organization of the work. They can take their time looking at charts and graphs and pictures. They can look up the definitions of unfamiliar words, and they can take their time rereading to get whatever depth of understanding they want. But when your audience is sitting there listening to you speak, they don't have the luxury of re-listening And they certainly don't have the luxury of having all these organizational guideposts sitting there in front of them. You have to provide clearly audible and visual indicators of the organizational structure. And because they have to process everything they're seeing and hearing in real time, it's good to use images and words that are familiar and relatable to them. And to really drive home the important points that you really want them to remember, it's good if you package them in vivid imagery and anecdotes and stories. And speaking of vivid imagery, let's now talk about visual aids. In an essay or a blog post, you can include detailed descriptions and complex charts and graphs and illustration. But in a speech, visual aids that are overly complex or attract too much attention to themselves will actually distract the listener from listening to you. And in the worst case, the listener would become so distracted that they would actually stop listening to you altogether. So when you're considering what visual aids to use in your next speech, consider these questions. Will the visual aid help the audience visualize an idea better? Will it help evoke a stronger emotion? Will it help illustrate an important concept in your speech better? Now let's talk about the most important of these six essential elements of a speech, and that is you, the speaker. When it comes to written works like essays and blog posts, the author is almost invisible, and we only perceive them through their writing style. And the only way they get their message across is through words and word combinations. But the speaker, unlike the virtually invisible author, is physically or at least virtually present during the speech. And their appearance and their energy level and their confidence and their delivery style can sometimes have very profound effects on the listener's experience of their speech. And now let's talk about the final essential element of a great speech, talk, or presentation, and that is its delivery. When a writer publishes an essay or a blog post, it doesn't really matter what physical, mental, or emotional state they were in while they were writing it. All that matters to the reader is the quality of the writing and the impact it has on their life. In a speech, however, it's almost the opposite. It is the physical, mental, and emotional state of the speaker when they're delivering the speech that determines the overall quality. And that, unfortunately, is somewhat independent of how long you've spent crafting and practicing it. To help you remember these six essential elements of spoken communication, it helps to group them into pairs and think of yourself as an archer shooting an arrow at a target. The audience and the speaking context are the target. The content and the visual aids are the arrow, and the speaker and their delivery are the archer and the bow. So, speak your mind, I wish you well as you shoot your arrows into the hearts and minds of your listeners. And if you found this video valuable to you, hit the subscribe button and the bell notification, and I'll see you in the next video.